I was never able to shake Kazantzakis' hand. He died as I was getting on the plane to go to Geneva, meet him for the first time, and live with him. It was one of the big sorrows of my life, maybe a blessing in a mournful disguise, because I approached his work with a lot more thirst. His philosophy is impossible to change because it is life itself. And today, his philosophy is as valid as life itself because it is based on life and its constant change. This change is what we have to realize and take advantage of. The conflict of Kazantzakis was not with real religion, but with religion as it is usually used, as a system of imposing fear and then power. God as a spontaneous feeling, as a question or as a certainty, can lead you to many discoveries, even to his gods, that is, to his non-existence. Because by nature Kazantzakis was born in the world and psychologically is him that chose Crete as his country. But naturally, he felt at home in many countries, in the south of France especially, because the climate psychologically is such that everyone can feel at home. From what I know, Kazantzakis never left his physical life. His body problems interfere with what he wanted to do for the world. I was told that he always appeared where he was supposed to, even if he were in pain. All my life I lived under his shadow. All my life he was my godfather, my great chance. The fact that I never met him was always a great sorrow for me, a great sorrow. And I think that it's under him that I started to dare and write my own little poems. But it was like a pebble in front of a big statue. That's how I felt. But also, we must not forget that I lived with Eleni Kazantzaki, Kazantzaki's wife, in Geneva, and that we were very close and very, very close together. She's like my parent.